Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I want to greet every one of you who are on this broadcast. Thank you for your consistency. Thank you for your prayers. And each time you send in a testimony to what God is doing through this commission, you encourage me. Thank you. God bless in the name of Jesus Christ. You would have heard it that in August, we are planning what we call August Special. It is not a new program. It has been there over the years. August Special. It's always a one-month program. We capture the making of a man of God. And there we train pastors and we do other programs that has to still do with the PNOC mandate of prayer and revival. But this year, God has given us room to go beyond our borders. So we are having the online session of School for Deliverance and Spiritual Warfare. It's a one-month intensive program. A one-month intensive program on training on deliverance and spiritual warfare. And I always tell people who tell me, why do we bother about the training? The truth of the matter is that that's a mistake the church is making. When somebody wants to be an army, he don't just give me a gun to go into the battlefield. That is simply killing the person. And the person who does that just commits suicide. But unfortunately, in the church today, when people want to do anything, they just move in. They just go in. Some say, oh, I know how to do it. You look at one or two persons and they tell you that they do this. So you follow them and do it. And every now and then we receive testimonies or crises. I remember when I was growing up in the ministry, my mother told me a man somewhere in the three villages of my own village that the man became mad because he wanted to destroy a shrine. There was another case of somebody in Abadan who went to pray for a madman. He also became mad and sat there with a madman. There are those who have gone to carry out deliverance programs and they have had issues. And there are those who don't know the power of God that is available to them. And they are running from place to place using the wrong methods. Some are praying prayers that God will never answer because they don't know the word of God. Some resort to mysticism, go to occult, some go to all kinds of things, go to mystic shops looking for things. Even some of them, I remember a lady who came around to me, a faithful daughter of Zion, and I've been in the faith for years, and she went to one of these mommy water women that had seen her somewhere and said they had seen vision. And I asked her why. She said she wants to hear from God. I said, don't you know you can hear from God? And there are senses like that, because the believers need to be trained. You need to be trained. You need to understand what it means to be a Christian. You need to understand how the devil himself operates. And you need to understand the authority that the Lord Jesus Christ has made available to you. In School for Deliverance and Spiritual Warfare, we call it Scientific School for Deliverance and Spiritual Warfare. And that means we teach people deliverance and spiritual warfare from the background where they can look at what they are doing and understand what they are doing. And I can tell you that more than 20 books available in this school were written by me. And I challenge you to take a look at any of my books. You will not see stolen information, because these are the things that God has rubbed through my life. And I was able to put them down because God passed me through it. I always give you this scripture, 2 Corinthians 1 from 3 to 4, where the Bible says we give God thanks to the God of comfort, God of all mercy, who comforts us in all our trouble, that we may be able to comfort others with the comfort wherewith ourselves we have been comforted by God. So some things that God does through my ministry are the things he made me to experience. He made me to test them, and I know them by experience. And these are the things that I teach. But this year's for deliverance is exceptional because, the August special is wonderful because I am bringing in some other men of God. It's a one-month intensive program. We are looking at having 4 days teaching, 4 days every week. And of course, we'll take it in the evening. Those of you who are in our different time zones, we pray that God will help you. But we tend to have it at 8 p.m. And we have to still discuss with the students to choose the best days to put in these 4 days. And our other ministers will be calling in to enter the school to teach and to train. So you need to have a good understanding of the deliverance and spiritual warfare. You need to understand, the power of God available to you. And this year's August special, we captioned it, Encounter with Supernatural Power. Encounter with Supernatural Power. And I want to tell you that every one of us needs this encounter. If you look at Acts of the Apostles chapter 9, Apostle Paul was going to confront the children of God at Damascus. He was leading an army against them, but he had an encounter there. It was a lifetime encounter, and he turned around to serve Jesus. I can tell you that many people who are persecuting the church, who are saying something against the church, if they meet genuine power encounter, they are going to turn around and serve Jesus. The problem is that today, the church is more like impotent because of our carelessness, because of our worldliness. Some things we do don't leave it in. And you see that people are still going to church because they know they love God. They want to meet with God. But when they come to church, they're not able to meet God. We see such an instance in Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19. Verse 17, when this became known to the Jews and Greeks living in Ephesus, they were all seized with fear, and the name of the Lord Jesus was held in high honor. Many of those who believed now came and openly confessed what they had done. A number who had practiced sorcery brought their scrolls together and burned them publicly. When they calculated the value of the scrolls, the total came to 50,000 drachmas. In this way, the word of the Lord spread widely and grew in strength. Now, this is a very interesting story. Some people in Ephesus had Apostle Paul believe, and they accepted the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. But they did not trust that they can be protected under the banner of this gospel. Even though they believed, they were baptized. Bible said in chapter 19, verse 11 of Acts of the Apostles, that they saw great miracles happening through Apostle Paul. They saw that people can take the handkerchief and Paul will touch it, and they will go out and will heal the sick and cast out demons. They saw great, but they also felt that this was part of mysticism. They also felt that this was part of occult. I've had people who say that all these great ministries that manifest great power, they are resorting to occult. So these people who have believed, those who have been joined to the church, they were still keeping occult materials. They were still keeping witchcraft materials in their homes. And I want to tell you that it is happening today. Some people in Freemason, some people in one society or the other, they are in church. They are still keeping their properties, the properties of their occult. They don't want to surrender. There are people even that don't want to get baptized. They say, oh, I'll be coming to church. I'll be coming small, and things like that. And that was the situation as at that time, that in spite of all the great miracles that the Apostle Paul was performing and the many souls that we have been saved, Bible said that there are people in the church who are still practicing witchcraft, who are still practicing sorcery. And I can say it happens today. And now something happened because some people thought that Apostle Paul was doing this thing by sorcery, and they saw the name of Jesus Christ as one of the magic names that they can use to cast out demons and make their money. So they started their own ministry. People who didn't know the Lord Jesus, people who were not genuinely born again, Bible said in Acts 19 from verse 13, that the people went about going from place to place, and they will meet a demonized person. They say, come out, you demon, in Jesus' name. And the demons obeyed them and came out. I've always repeated this to my students in the school for deliverance and spiritual warfare, that this shows you that you can cast out demons. If an unbeliever could cast out demons, how much more are you able to cast out demons? So then we are doing this until some popular fellows, they became popular because they were known as the source of Sceva, a Jewish high priest and the chief priest, and they went out and they were doing this thing until one time a demon challenged the seven of them and gave them the beating of their life and threw them out. And the people around say, wow, so this name of Jesus is not the same as this name of all these slave gods we worship. Does it mean that this name of Jesus is not the same with the name of the mystic shop? I've been warning you that don't ever go to the mystic shop to buy anything. Say, this name of Jesus, is it not, it's different. And Bible says fear came on them. And people stopped talking with the name of Jesus. And Bible says the number of people who have been involved in sorcery, who have been involved in occult, who have bought books of mysticism, who have brought this and that into their life. Bible says they came out openly and confessed what they have done. And they packed out all the books. And the Bible says that they were able to destroy about 50,000 drachmas of material. I can tell you that that amount today is up to $500,000. And that is why serving Satan is expensive. Serving Satan is costly. It's unfortunate that when people come around to the kingdom of light, they begin to complain. When they tell them to bring offering, they complain. Say, so see, they complain. Ask those that are serving Satan. They will tell you how expensive serving Satan is. A man once told me how to baptize him. The native doctor, whatever he's called, or mystic man, say he had to pay 400,000 naira. And he paid the 400,000 naira, the man dug ground and baptized him in water. One brother told me how, after spending all this money, he and his wife we are made to sleep in a shallow grave. They dug a grave, and his wife sleep, and they kill animals and sprinkle blood on them. And they pass a night there, and yet he not get a solution. And we have all that kind of instances going on. And today, all kind of fake prophets and fake pastors that God have shut them up with the corona pandemic, all these things are still operational. And that is why there is a call upon every child, genuine child of God, to stand up and manifest the real power. When people see this kind of thing going on, most people think that there is no difference between the genuine Christian and the fake Christians. And so when that there was that show of power and God manifested himself, and that is what I'm crying to God for. That's why we in PNUR, we are crying to God that he will manifest himself so all these kind of people will be exposed. But you see the people in the church, they were believers. Bible says those that had believed, they were born again, they were children of God. So quarrel with me about this. They were born again, our God children, but they needed something to protect their confidence. Their heart was failing them. They could not properly separate from the past. They could not properly separate from Satan. They still believe that Satan has some kind of power. They have to use some kind of stamp to protect themselves. If you are in that category and you're listening to me today, that is wrong. Satan's power is different from God's power. Bible said in John chapter 10, verse 10, that when devil comes, he comes to steal, he comes to steal, he comes to destroy. That's what he comes to do. And when Jesus Christ comes, he comes to give you life, an abundant life. In Matthew 11, 28, he said, come to me, you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He said, come and take my yoke. My yoke is easy. My body is light, and you will find rest for your soul. Jesus Christ and Satan, they are not the same. In in John chapter 8, 44, Jesus Christ says, Satan is a murderer and a thief. And when a liar, and when he speaks his mother, he speaks a lie, he speaks his mother's tongue, for there is no truth in him, and he does not uphold the truth. And in the same Bible, in John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. And the Bible also says in 1 John 3, verse 8, he said, whoever commits sin is of the devil, because devil has been sinning from the beginning. And the reason the Son of God was manifested is to destroy the devil's work. So Satan's work and God's work cannot come together. Jesus is light. Satan is darkness. So if you are today, you're listening to me, you still wear some beads, you go from native doctors, you still carry some charms, some ring, and you are in church, and you say, okay, what I want to go to church, I put it in the house, you are in a great error. And I want to tell you, if you want to enjoy the power of God, if you want to enjoy the glory of God, you have to bring out all those things from your house and get them destroyed. And I want to tell you something, if you need help, you can reach me, you can get my contact after this broadcast. But the interesting thing is that when the people saw the power of God, they cannot say, yes, this is the kind of place I want to stake my life. And I want to tell the churches and those who are following me to understand that the world is waiting to see God's power. Somewhere in 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 24, a woman said to Elijah, now I know that you are a true man of God, and the word that came from your mouth is true. It is strange that this woman is the woman that we call the woman of Zarephath. The woman that gave Elijah some water and some food, and the food in her house kept multiplying. Yet the woman did not conclude that Elijah was a genuine man of God. In spite of the provision of food and provision of water, the woman still doubted that something about Elijah. It was the day that her son died. And when Elijah prayed and brought back her son to life, that was the day the woman said, "Now I know you are a genuine man of God." I want to tell the pastors who listen to me, if they hear this, people are still doubting the genuineness of your ministry. They are still doubting it. The only thing that will cure them is power. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19, verse 20, Bible says, when this thing became known, and when people saw what God had done, and people brought out their occult materials, he said the word of God spread rapidly. He spread all over the place, because all those sin in the church, unbelief in the church, occult in the church, witchcraft in the church, all those things are strangulating the power of God. They are hindering the flow of the genuine power of God. It is when those things are taken away, when the hearts of the people are not open, the power cannot flow. When those obstacles are taken away, the power flows. Oh my God. And that is why I'm inviting you to be part of the School for Doctrine and Spiritual Warfare. Now listen, in this August special, it's a very, very special one. We'll be training. I'll be there. All of you that know me, I can tell you that I have what it takes to train people. I'm an authority in deliverance and spiritual warfare. I've written more than 30 books that deal with deliverance and spiritual warfare. You don't want to meet any book in this school I did from somebody. You don't want to also see in my material something I copied from somebody. Confronting witchcraft in the neighborhood, how to overcome spiritual and white problem. You can't ignore Satan and his demons. There are a whole lot of them that I've written. Books that deal with debt, like Covenants. That is the best-selling title. No church, no organization, no ministry, no preacher in the world has a book that equals to Covenants, how they affect people. My teaching on family tree, saying to family tree, is first class. No other book in the world. I challenge you to go through that book and prove me wrong. No other author in the world have the depth revealed in these books, because those things, they came from the Lord. They came by inspiration. And that is why, beyond asking to buy the books, I want you to register for School for Doctrine and Spiritual Warfare, the August special. You will get information as you stay on the platform, or you can send a personal message to me via WhatsApp, as I will give the number. So I'm inviting every believer to prepare for supernatural encounter with supernatural power in August special 2020. I want you to leave everything you're doing, map out time. Now we have time. Map out time and be part of it. Get involved. Don't be passively involved. I was telling one of my followers yesterday, I said, reduce distraction. Some groups you belong to on social media, they're just wasting your energy. They are wasting your energy and wasting your data. Some people on Facebook, there's one app I have on Facebook, immediately a video comes up, you just begin to play the video. At times, before you know it, you already spent 30 minutes watching a senseless video that is taking you nowhere. You have to know how to disconnect from all those things. I use this period to prepare yourself. I assure you that God will keep you through this period of this global pandemic. And I want you also to prepare that when you're coming out of this pandemic, you're coming with your testimony. So, a encounter with supernatural power, August special 2020. I'm inviting you, and I pray that God will do great things in your life. I pray that God will empower you. I pray that God will protect you. I pray that you also will encounter God's power in the month of August. Remain under this anointing. Remember, it's your brother in my angel Wosu. +234 8035724526. Remain under this anointing. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.